Hi, New Jersey 101.5. It's Big Joe Henry. We're very proud to welcome to the big show. He is a Rock and Roll Hall of Famer, an E Street Band member, guitarist, singer extraordinaire. Ladies and gentlemen, our own Nils Lofgren is in the house. Nils.
Appreciate it, Big Joe.
Well, Nils, I appreciate you taking time to be part of the show. Some body of work you had there, pal. You front the band Grin at the age of 17. At the age of 18, you're with Neil Young. After the Gold Rush, a big hit, of course, and then you go on and hook up with Bruce Springsteen in 1984, which leads to your induction into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. You got to be pretty proud about that.
You know, I'm thankful. The reason I got noticed was because of being in Bruce's band, which is great, but it's all good. The main thing for me is walking out in front of people. They let me know where I'm at and how I'm doing, and it's very honest expression of what they thought of what I did, and that's the purest form of music for me, is performing.
Well, it is, and you know, listen, perform. You have you put out a 10 CD retrospective of your solo music called Face the Music, and the liner notes that you received from Bruce, Sting, and Neil Young were just were very flattering to you.
Yeah, I was grateful. It was, you know, a 10-disc box set with a DVD. Dave Morris insisted I write the 138-page book, and he helped me edit it, but it's in my voice, closest thing to a book I'll ever write. And I got some great old... Amy produced the artwork and did a beautiful package. Our old friend Steve Smolin out of Baltimore had all the old 45 sleeves and old posters. I mean, when Grin opened for Jimi Hendrix Experience on my 19th
wow.
birthday, he had a poster. And, you know, it's a beautiful package I'm proud of. The website's cool. It's nilslofgren.com. Got a lot of free music and video there. I just did an unusual thing you could check out there. There's some clips called Blind Date Jam. The theme is people get together and play, and there's no homework. There's no tapes. Nobody knows what they're going to do. And I hit them with an idea, and we just jam. It's rough and raw. And it shows you what happens when musicians that like to jam don't know what's going to happen. And, you know, I've been involved with thousands of hours of that no one ever gets to see or hear. So that's another thing people might want to check out. But I'm working on a new album. It's mostly electric. I feel great about it.
Great.
Hoping to have it done at the end of the year and out in spring and just keep playing.
Man, it's nonstop with you, though. You know, the great thing is that when Bruce went through a little bit of a hiatus, you hooked up with Ringo Starr and his all-star band, and you've worked with so many people. You did the Beatles tribute. You went on back on tour with Amnesty International. I mean, you never stop. You never stop, and it's that's your passion for music that you have.
Yeah, well, you know, you realize it's funny. In '89, I was, thanks to Bruce and the E Street tours on Born in the USA, when we were in London, went to a birthday party for Ringo and got to jam with him and established a friendship, and he started coming to see me play. And in '89, he asked me to join his first all-star band, which was such a great honor.
Wow, yeah.
The first couple. But even he was like, well, you know, he's in the greatest band ever. To me, the greatest body of music ever recorded, the Beatles. And it was neat. He said, look, you know, I've got money, I've got fame, but I'm a drummer. I need to figure out how to drum. You can't top the Beatles. And to his credit, he came up with this round robin thing where everyone sang two or three songs. He got to be a front man for three or four numbers, but play drums the rest of the night and be in a band. And he's still doing it. He's coming up on his 30th year, and he's going out. He's up and rehearsing right now to head out again. God bless him. It's people like that that like broke the ground for me, and you know, Bruce, Stevie, all of us, and that I can still have a series of shows to get excited about, put together, knowing people will come and see me. Got a lot of beautiful memories in New Jersey, and very excited to get back to the Pony to do a good show for everybody.
Well, we're excited to have you back. Of course, the big show coming up, Nils Lofgren Acoustic Duo at the world-famous Stone Pony in Asbury Park. It happens Tuesday, September the 18th. Great show. I look forward to it. I'll see you there for sure. For tickets, go to Ticketmaster.com. The big show starts at 7 o'clock. And I'll tell you what, I've seen your live show. There's no skipping on talent. You put on a big show. I'm really looking forward to it.
Yeah, I'll be playing some Strat and jamming out, too. We got a real colorful, whole passionate, great musical night for everyone. So appreciate you spreading the word, Big Joe.
Oh, you got it. You know that, Nils. It's always a pleasure to have you on the air. And thank you for being part of New Jersey, and congratulations on all your success.
tell all my Jersey friends, please come down and see us. We'll do a special night for you.
I will.
Appreciate it, Big Joe. Thanks for spreading the word. We'll see you at the Stone Pony.
You're darn right you will. Thanks, Nils.
All the best. Thanks.
All right, pal.